Hello everyone. Welcome to Success Stories with Surabhi. My name is Surabhi Negamtula. Today we have a very special corporate professional with us. His name is Mr. Sandeep Nagpal. He is currently Vice President Marketing with Cvent. Hello Mr. Nagpal, welcome to you for the show.
Hi Surabhi, it's always great to talk to you.
Great.
Thank you for having me.
Pleasure is all mine. So Mr. Nagpal, why don't you share something about yourself? Yeah.
Sure. Surabhi, you already introduced me. I currently work for Cvent as a vice president of marketing. Been in the industry for about 2.5 decades. Started my career in about 93.
Wow.
Basically a mechanical engineer. Come from a 4G family.
Wow.
So been in the country, in various parts of the country. Before I went for my engineering in Pune, I was in Punjab for some time and did my schooling from there. Did my engineering in Pune, as I said. Then I started my career in a brick and mortar industry, right? So I started my career with a company called Denso as a design engineer, right? And very soon in my career, I realized that, you know, design is not my cup of tea. I was more of a techno-commercial person in that sense. So moved from there, worked for various multinationals, worked for Honda, worked for New Holland Tractors, worked for Canon. Most of it was in the techno-commercial field. And towards 98, 99 is when the computer bug caught me in some sense, because that was a time when we were studying, computers were scarce, right? So you can call me dinosaur in that sense, right? So, '99 is when I was in New Holland Tractors, when I actually got an interface with computers, and I was implementing ERP system functionally for them. And that's when, things changed. You know, my love for computers, my understanding for computers started increasing. And you call me lucky. I got a call from a headhunter to for an interview with Microsoft in 2000, and I was like wondering why would Microsoft be interested in me? It was as the luck would have it, I went through the cycle of interviews, and there I was. You know, I was hired by Microsoft in the year 2000, and then after that, it has been the software industry. For almost now, what, 2 decades? Nokia, maybe was in Microsoft for about 8-9 years, then worked for Nokia as mobility head, then moved to SAP, you know, worked for SAP for like close to about 8 years, various functions. I was in an Asia Pacific role as a vice president, and then I moved back. Started working for this incredible company called Cvent, which is basically into the hospitality and events. And I run the global marketing for them from India. So that's what I have done as a professional. If that kind of covers my initial introduction, and we'll go with the flow.
I kept on saying wow at each moment. You know, people think about the brands, even if they work for one brand, it's amazing. And you worked for around so many, which is very profound.
Yeah, I've been lucky, I would say.
Luck only comes to those who people work for it only, which is great.
Thank you.
Good, glad. So, Mr. Nagpal, what is success for you?
Well, I think success, has very different meanings for different people. For me, I think it's about satisfaction. It's more, do I enjoy what I do, right?
Yeah.
Whether it's personal or professional, I have always looked at a job in a way that, whenever I took a job, in fact, I would say after I joined Microsoft, I think that was a very incredible moment for me in my life. Very overwhelming, but very incredible moment. Wow. But that also taught me a lot of stuff related to success.
Sure.
You know, a lot of people who would have joined would have taken it as a success that, joining Microsoft at that time was like very few people used to work for Microsoft at that time, right? So for me, it was definitely a success. But That journey taught me a lot because I changed like three or four roles in about 9 years. And what happened was that the company gave me great opportunities. And after that, almost every company gave that opportunity to me. But what happened was that for me, important thing was, why am I taking this role? Why am I doing this? Right?
Why are you doing this?
Am I going to join? Am I going to contribute to this? Can I look back and say, I built something, you know? And I never looked for like, can I work for this company for 10 years, right? I always look for, can I look at this company for like, hey, I did a great job, you know, I left something great as a legacy, right? So for me, every role was a success journey in that sense, right? I succeeded in some, I didn't succeed in some, which will always be the case. But it's always momentarily, right? So momentarily you feel disillusioned that I couldn't achieve something. Then you feel, you know, you take another path and you make some things about it. You enjoy the journey and you say, hey, you know what? I really succeeded. So I think success is never an absolute thing. It's always a journey. You keep
Ongoing,
getting your milestones, and every milestone you celebrate, and then you say, next journey, right? So I think
Absolutely.
so every milestone is a success in that sense.
Brilliant. So, whatever the journey which you have shared so far, what are the five key things which you have worked upon specifically, and that's why you are so successful in corporate
Again, I mean, success is relative, so I'm humbled
world?
and you're too generous for that. But I can tell you what works for me. Okay, I think I can probably say three to four things. One was keeping your values intact, right? Why do you need to have your own values, right? You
Absolutely.
know, don't compromise on your values early in the game and whatever. You should never compromise on your values, right? So, second was, you know, perseverance. So, you know, मेरा एक बॉस होता था, वो ही यूज्ड टू से, यू नो, लगे रहो, यू नो. सो परसिवरेंस इज ऑल अबाउट लगे रहो, राइट? डोंट लूज हार्ट. यू नो, थिंग्स विल कम, थिंग्स विल गो, राइट? सम थिंग्स विल वर्क, सम थिंग्स विल नॉट वर्क. बट इफ योर जर्नी इज राइट, इफ योर, यू नो, इफ व्हाटएवर यू काइंड ऑफ गोइंग आफ्टर, इफ दैट्स राइट एंड यू नो इट इज राइट एंड योर मेथड्स आर राइट, यू कीपिंग योर वैल्यूज इन द सिस्टम, आई थिंक सक्सेस इज अ फोरगॉन कंक्लूजन इन दैट सेंस, राइट? इट कम, राइट? द थर्ड थिंग आई वुड से इज पीपल, यू नो, बिल्ड रिलेशनशिप्स.
Absolutely.
एंड आई ऑलवेज, यू नो, वेन एवर आई टॉक टू दी एमबीए स्टूडेंट्स एंड अदर्स एंड ऑल स्टफ, आई ऑलवेज से रिलेशनशिप्स शुड नेवर बी बिल्ट विद अ मोटिव ऑफ गेटिंग समथिंग बैक.
Absolutely.
इट
Zero
शुड बी
down
लाइक,
to this.
you know, it's like a mutual fund, SIPs, right? Keep investing, keep investing, keep investing. At some point of time, it will, you know, have an incredible value for you, and it'll create wealth for you, right? And wealth is, again, you know, in metaphorical terms, but that's how it is, you know. So I think these are the three things that have always kept me going. Other than that, I think I am also a believer that you know, faith and patience. To have a
Faith
faith
and
in
patience.
faith, you know, have faith in your ability, your team's ability, your people's around and all the stuff, and then keep patience, you
True.
know, nothing comes quick. Rome was not built in a day, so nothing comes. So I think that's probably been few things that I have kind of kept with me. That also brings me to a very interesting anecdotal thing that happened with me, you know, now that you brought it up. Very early in my career, you know, there was this manager of mine. Well, he was not directly manager, but quite senior guy. Rest in peace, he's no more. But he was one guy who told me very interesting thing. I was a young rookie in one of the companies, and he, I was very frustrated one day. You know, ये क्यों नहीं हो रहा है, कुछ होता नहीं है, ये नहीं है. You know, your manager was being tough on you. मैं ये नहीं करूंगा, मेरे से ये नहीं होता, यू नो, ऑल दोस काइंड ऑफ, यू नो, यंग गाइस, यू नो, आवर किड्स डू इट. तो ही मेंशन टू मी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग, ही सेड, यू नो, you beta, you understand what is naukri? And I said, naukri matlab nokar, nokar matlab no nakra. Okay, so it was very interesting anecdotal old wisdom, and that is one thing that left with me, was always with me in my most of the organization. That
Sure.
when you're doing a job, you're doing a job. Don't carry your ego and nakra and all of
Yeah.
that stuff. I mean, keep your values, but keep your ego aside,
Ego
right? So I think
aside.
that also worked a lot, part of my success journey, I would say. So
Great.
hopefully
So
that
I was
answers.
about to ask you this question. What are the things which you have not done? So you have
Exactly.
one thing you have mentioned that don't do
Exactly.
nakra
Yeah. Yeah, and Nakra is not a, I mean, Nakra in different sense is good, but I think in job,
Doesn't
Nakra
work.
doesn't work. Yeah.
Right.
So I think, yeah, Nakra or ego is one thing that I would never, I would recommend not to carry with you.
हाँ, तो एक क्विक चीज ये है कि जब कई बार आप किसी लेवल पे पहुंच रहे होते हैं तो आपको पता भी नहीं चलता कि आपके अंदर ईगो आ गया है. उसके लिए व्हाट आर द साइंस, हाउ पीपल वुड नो दैट?
I think more than science, Surbhi, I go back and look at what I just said to you about relationships.
या
Right? You always need to have a mentors and people
या
around you who
एब्सोल्युटली.
can bring you down, right? So that's an interesting question. I have mentors outside of the industry,
या
outside of my own set of people that I meet every day and all this stuff. So
या
I am able to talk to people from manufacturing, from pharmaceutical, from other companies, not from software industry, because we talk the same lingo, same language, same problem, same
ट्रू
everything. So, and everybody's problems are similar, industry is similar. So you need to have senior people who have seen the life from different aspects of life. And you need to have an ability to have a chat and even take a world wisdom from them. And they will
Yeah.
point out to you, if you have the real people who you have good relationship with unbiased opinions, they'll bring you down in like 2 minutes, right? And
Absolutely.
say, "Tu galat kar raha hai, this is not done, right? So this is
Yeah.
not, this hasn't worked for me. This hasn't worked for, this kind of stuff." So
Anybody, yeah.
I think that if you surround yourself with mentors and right kind of
Yeah.
people and build those relationships, I think that helps to
That
keep
helps.
your, ego down and all that stuff, and it kind of levels you up. Yeah.
Absolutely. Very, very amazing point which you have said, because लोगों को पता ही नहीं चलता कि वो ईगो ट्रिप पे आ गए हैं या क्या है. लोग उनको खींच के नीचे ले आते हैं अगर मेंटर्स होते हैं आसपास. ऐसा काम स्पाउसेस भी करती हैं वैसे.
देखो, वो जो फोरगोन चीजें हैं ना, उनको तो आप यू कैन नॉट डिनाई दैट, राइट? सो वो
या
दैट इज राइट. तो
बट राइट
या
मेंटर्स आर इम्पोर्टेंट. ग्रेट.
दैट्स राइट.
सो वन थिंग यू वॉन्ट आवर व्यूअर्स टू नो अबाउट और यू वॉन्ट टू लीव अ मैसेज, एनीथिंग विच यू वॉन्ट टू शेयर?
Yeah, I mean, I think not a message, but I would definitely want to say that as you start your journey in your careers, or when you're mid-level people who are
Right.
looking at, I would always recommend that don't run after. So two things that gives me interesting. Two
Sure.
things. One, never run after money. Okay. If you're doing the right thing and if you're following your passion, if you if you know what you're going after, money will follow. It's a done deal.
Money will flow in automatically.
It will follow. It will follow.
True.
There is
I
no option
agree.
that will not follow, right?
I
So
agree. Yeah.
I think if you follow money, it'll वो आगे भागेगा, right? So
हाँ
there's no end to it, right? So
हाँ आप हमेशा पीछे हैं.
आप पीछे हैं, क्योंकि कोई आपका ऐसा साथी जरूर होगा जो आपसे आगे निकल जाएगा, फिर आप उसके पीछे भागोगे फिर. तो
वाह.
यू हैव टू हैव योर ओन गोल एंड योर ओन पैशन. फॉलो योर
या
पैशन. आई थिंक that's very critical. The other thing
राइट.
that another manager of mine actually said, and I kind of kept it with me for very long, still carrying it, is don't create and don't live in a toxic culture,
Very true.
right?
Very true.
So as a manager, if you are a manager, don't create a toxic culture of work environment around you, even in family. Otherwise,
Right.
you can't cut your losses. But in a work environment, if you are in accidentally into a toxic culture or whatever, try and
Yeah.
cut your losses fast, right? And
Right.
find out something that works for you and is
True.
not hindering on your personal values and all that stuff. So I think those are the two things. Don't follow the money, and money will
Toxic
follow. So
friends.
again, both of them were actually given to me by one of my manager, and I kind of kept it with me. And I think
Yeah.
that's worked for me. And I would probably pass on the baton to a lot of other people to really ponder
Right.
upon this. It'll work for some, it'll not work for some, but
Right.
generally that has worked for me.
Absolutely brilliant. Thank you so much for sharing your amazing wisdom with us. And thank you so much for coming on the show for us. Thank you
Thank
so
you.
much again.
Thank you
Bye-bye.
so much.